5 foes are legion. These 5 are potentially problematic. A noble predator, he believes himself to be. This Gurok wild speaker, brutal savage, merely a merciless killer. His impatience is my virtue. Jace Beleren's greatest strength is his greatest flaw. A supremely powerful mind incapable of perceiving how he could rule all. A keystone in an unfathomable plan. So utterly filled with power, so wholly lacking in restraint and vision, seeking freedom. Will Chandra Nalar rise above personal retribution, or will her fury consume all? A dark power commanding the dead. Liliana Vess inspires terror. In debt to demons, entranced in a pursuit of unattainable desires. As ruthless as myself. Reinforcer of life, light, and strength in allies. A contemptible blight. Should we cross again, I'll snuff a Johnny Goldmane's spark, consigning him to an endless night.
Hey guys, the dude from Denmark here. So Magic the Gathering Duels of the Planeswalker 2013 have been released today, so let's check the features out. The clip I showed you in the start of the video were a clip from this game when it started, where Nicholas Bolas, a planeswalker, talks about how you are weak and how he will destroy everything you own and so on.
For if you dare face me, destroying you shall be my pleasure.
The menu has the typical things the other games had, multiplayer and helps and options, achievement, custom games, downloadable contents and so on. A new thing in this game is that you have a player status where you can go and see achievements that you recently got and what colors you're playing the most and who have you beaten lately and so on. This is a nice thing to keep track of what have happened lately, which I think is kind of neat and a fun thing to see. In this game we of course have a campaign mode where you get to defeat a lot of enemies before you go to your main goal target enemy, which is Nicholas Bolas of course. The neat thing here is that one of the modes you are going to play through before getting to Nicholas Bolas is that you're going to play Plane Chase. And Plane Chase is really fun. If you don't know what Plane Chase is, it's all about being on planes and have to skip through planes that does something. For example, that every time you cast a creature spell, you put out tokens, or every time a creature die, target player have to do something and so on. And then you can roll a die to get away from those planes if you don't like them. It's a really neat thing, really fun. The plane chase mode is not only in the campaign. If you want to play plane chase, you can also play it through custom games, which is really nice. The plane chase mechanic seems to work really well in this game. Although the opponent seems to want to get away from the planes you're on all the time. So every time it's their turn, they want to roll the dice to get away, which is really annoying if you just want to stay there. Even if you're on a plane that benefits the opponent even more than you, they seem to want to get away anyway. So it's a bit weird, I think. People have complained a lot about that in previous Duel of the Planeswalker games you couldn't tap your mana manual. So that means that the computer just would tap mana for you, which could be annoying if you wanted to save a special color mana for something special. In this new game you can do it, but it's not in every scenario you can do it. If you're playing a mono color deck with only one color, you can't do it. But if you play a deck with more colors and you have some mana out where there, for example, is two green and two black manas out, you can point at the card you want to play, and then tap through the mana you want to use by left clicking the left control button. It's really nice that they added this, but it may be better if they added so you could manually tap all the time. But Wizard of the Coast talked about that they wanted to not have this option to manually doing it every time, because that would just be annoying in the long run for players, and especially new players. It's really nice that they added this, but it may be better if they added so you could manually tap all the time. But Wizard of the Coast talked about that they wanted to not have this option to manually doing it every time, because that would just be annoying in the long run for players, and especially new players. It's a little preview of the new Duel of the Planeswalker game. If you want, you can leave me a comment down below telling me what you think about this game, if you hate it or if you love it, or what do you think of it. I will be putting up some gameplay footage of the new game, and some gameplay for Plane Chase and just a normal custom game. So if you're interested in that, you can subscribe to me to see these videos when they come up. So until next time, have fun, guys.